Anybody want to help me figure out what that sign means?
Morning. Today is day 57. When you guys see this, it'll be the 28th, which is the 15-year anniversary of my friend Megan passing away. And I'm really not sure how to give someone a fitting tribute or any kind of a tribute that's done so much. I've always said I feel like I can trace every good thing in my life back to her. I give her full credit for a million and one things. But yeah, I'm leaving San Juan, New Mexico right now. The goal is to make it to Super 8 and Tucumcari tonight and hopefully watch a little Survivor. All right, love you guys. New Mexico definitely has a different kind of beauty to it.
But this is still considered Route 66. It's just a really pretty area.
So I'm in Route 66 heading to Tucumcari, and a rancher slash farmer named Devin pulled over and he goes, "Let me give you my gun. It would make me feel better if I give you my pistol." I see a dog every day that they would go extinct if you gave me that thing. But he's a good man. Devin, thank you so much. You made my day. He was the coolest guy, man. I tell you, I was a little bit down today, to be honest with you. Yesterday, I cried my heart out thinking about Megan and just trying to figure out, you know, what I'm going to do with the video. And then I started listening to Lifehouse music because that was one of the last things me and Megan ever did together. We went to a Lifehouse concert. She loved Lifehouse. So I was a little down today. When you meet somebody like Devin, boy, does it lift your spirits. I just thought that was so funny. He tried to, oh man, please take my pistol. It would make me feel so much better. I mean, what a cool dude. I did not take it, by the way. Because if I would have, it would have looked like this. Pew, 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 pew. Pew. My shoes are starting to get run down. So I saw these two over here. Thought I'd try them on, see if they fit. Nah, that's about a size 13. I'm a 10. I think those shoes belong to the last person that trespassed.
Hi there, little buddies. What happened? Did this one fart?
I meant to put this in a previous video and I just forgot. The first time I walked across the country, it was always the same two types of people. A guy that was seeking another guy and an older married couple. Almost every time, those were the two types of people that would pull over, just, hey, you need anything, blah, blah. This time around, let me tell you, it has been every walk of life. I just had a lady that pulled over and said, she was trying to say, do you need a ride? Did not speak English. And I'm like, wow, like, first of all, like, a young woman, you know, for all they know, I'm a hitchhiker, a serial killer. I mean, I don't look all that great these days. And the language barrier. I mean, think how incredible that is, that we live in a world that people trust people that, you know, I am probably every red flag in the world if she was going to ask her family, like, hey, should I help this guy? You know what I mean? But like, you know, and on top of that, a language barrier. It's just, I believe in the good in people, and I wish everyone else did too.
I can't believe that's real life. Prior to the walk, I would eat $6 worth of pistachios every day. Anybody want to help me figure out what that sign means?
Oh, I know what it means. Nobody lives in New Mexico! One thing I love about New Mexico is it's totally normal to find a vertebrae just chilling in the middle of the road. Well, I wanted to do like a nice sunset time-lapse video and then put some Lifehouse music over it, but not exactly the best place for that. Tonight's hotel is brought to you by Steven. You guys maybe remember him from Oklahoma City. He's the one that took me out to have onion fried burgers for the first time. And I'll tell you more about him a little bit later. Actually, how about right now? So I admire Steven on so many levels. First of all, I've always said that the whole point of life is to be a grandparent. And I believe he's got like 14 grandkids or something, so crushing it. Also, because he made it very far along in the Survivor casting process, all the way to getting in front of everyone, Jeff Probst and everybody. And he looks at his time very differently in a fun, satisfied way, whereas my Survivor casting experience has haunted me to the point where I'm out here
again. So yeah, I really hope that I can look back on this experience the way he currently looks at his. Now, I knew he owned a machine shop, but I found this site that was connected to him called inspurrations.com. Like, tons of cool stuff made out of like spurs and stuff like that. But anyway, I totally want this lamp. Can you guys see me walk across the country with this thing? Just pew, 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 pew.
I did 22 miles today in just over 7 hours, which is okay considering tomorrow, which I'll tell you about later, is not going to be good.
Okay, so I'm mapping out the next half of this state, basically. And there's quite a few days with really long stretches because nobody lives here. And sleeping outside, which is miserable because I'm not equipped for this 30-degree weather. But if I don't put out a video, don't freak out, okay? Like, I have to be, like, really conservative with power and data and just everything, time. So I will text my mom every night as long as I'm getting service, but please don't freak out if I go a day or so without making a video. I do enjoy doing this, but at the same time, I have to be safe, you know what I mean, as much as possible.
Just got a shower, and I didn't feel like eating out of a gas station again, and the only place it would deliver was Chinese. So tonight's dinner is Chinese, brought to you by Shauna. Thank you, Shauna. I really appreciate it. The only thing that makes this meal better is the fact that I'm also watching Survivor! Oh, it's a commercial. All right, Shauna. Help me translate that. Oh crap, Survivor's back.
I've always said one of the most noble things you can do in life is to honor those that came before us. Unfortunately, when you lose someone, you have those emotions that you have to do something with. And I call that inspiration. And that inspiration, what you choose to do with it is your gift to them and their gift to you. And as soon as I get some closure to this survivor journey, the next goal is to get Lifehouse to do a memorial concert for Megan. That was one of the last things we did together. We went to a Lifehouse concert. So yeah, I'm forever grateful for the inspiration she's given me, that's for sure.